Hello, YouTube. They call me Phil, and welcome to Phil's Notebook page 202. Thanks for tuning into our little nickel and dime show. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe our show. Feel free to comment down below with your comments, your jokes, and your insults. And thanks again for tuning in to Phil's Notebook. Hi, Snowy. Good to see you. How are you doing today? Yeah, well, that's good. I'm glad you had a good time. Yeah, good. Well, by the way, who's playing with you in the band today? Oh, Rebecca. Rebecca, thanks for joining the show. Have fun today. Anyways, by the way, this is getting ridiculous. It's been really cold in America. I'm talking about really cold. Chicago was 60 degrees below zero. 60 degrees below zero. It was so cold, I saw a rat throw himself into a deep fryer at McDonald's. That's how cold it was. And speaking of Chicago, I was flying back from Chicago, and there was a young man who was sitting next to me, and he had some freshly caught crabs and a bottle of champagne. And the air stewardess came up to him before we took off and says, if you don't mind, we can put those crabs and champagne in the into a refrigerator so they'll be, they'll be safe and they'll be also stay fresh. So, of course, the young man said, no problem. And we landed after the 2.5 hour, 3 hour flight back home, as we were taxiing and the air stewardess gets on there and the microphone and tells everybody to remain seated until the plane comes to a complete stop. Then she also says this. Well, the guy who gave me the crabs in Chicago, please come forward. Yeah. Anyways, what? Yeah. Yes, no, that is a funny story. That is a funny. Definitely.
What?
Anyways, let's do our top 10 list. Here we go. Top 10 list. Top 10 signs there should not be a second date. Top 10 signs that there should not be a second date. I've definitely been there. Something about restraining orders, but that's a whole nother story. But anyways, top 10 signs there should not be a second date. Number 10, when your date asks if they can eat the stuff between your toes. Ew. Blech. Number 9, she says, just a guess, but have you ever done any sideshow work? Number 8, lovingly whispers, would you like to change my diaper? Number 7, she keeps making up with the other guy she brought along on the date. Been there. Number 6, when your date asked to see the wine list and you met for breakfast. I guess a liquid breakfast that would be. Number 5, she excuses herself to use the restroom at a different restaurant. Number 4, he's made up like Caitlyn Jenner. Scary, very scary. Number 3, when your date asks to put their teeth back in before the goodnight kiss. That one's scary too. Number 2, at the end of the evening, she passionately asks if she can have one of your ears. Alrighty, and here we go. Number 1, he says, you kiss even better than my mom. And there's your top 10 list right there. Okay, folks, well, as we're going into the summer season of television, this is where you get all the other shows, you know, that only come out during the summertime, like America's Got Talent and a few other of these shows that only come out during the summertime. So we thought here at Phil's Notebook that we would get you prepared for the new television summer season with a quiz of your television knowledge and help you get ready for that. So a little quiz for the for your television knowledge. So here we go with question number 1. What is the difference between the shows The Twilight Zone and The Kardashians? Is it A, The Twilight Zone has a new cast each week? B, Rod Serling introduced each episode of The Twilight Zone? Or C, The Twilight Zone only occasionally featured the adventures of hideous mutants? I don't know. I just like that question. Just do. Number two. The TV show Seinfeld is successful in syndication because A, its tremendously tremendous popularity, B, due to its mass saturation, or C, just another reason to hate Larry David. All right, number three. Children's TV programming is designed to A, to promote positive social attitudes, B, to give kids a head start in basic education, or C, to make sugar-coated cold sugar actually look nutritious. I don't know, I kind of like the sugar on top of sugar, you know? It's good stuff. Anyway, number four, TV insiders credit Netflix claim to be the number one streaming service to A, Adam Sandler, B, Chief Content Officer Ted Sarandos, or C, a deal with Satan. Number five. To boost ratings, CNN News has expanded its format to include A, more news about Donald Trump, B, more satellite interviews with world leaders, or C, a streetwise sidekick named Huggy Bear, the news dude. Huggy Bear. Huggy Bear, Snowy. You're too young to remember Huggy Bear. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Number six. The words, "This is not a true life documentary, but a fictionalized account," must appear before A, movies of the week, B, historical documentaries, or C, 9 out of 10 stories done by CNN's Jim Acosta. What? Yeah, yeah, I know. He's a weasel, isn't he? He's a big time weasel.
What? How is she? Wait, how is she talking?
Number seven. Wheel of Fortune has been a fixture on American television for 30 years because A, the fun in trying to solve the puzzle, B, watching contestants win big cash prizes, or C, Wheel of Fortune has been rerunning the same 12 episodes since 1998. Our final question, number eight. The ABC network canceled Schoolhouse Rock because A, the animation was looking old and outdated, B, it was costing too much to make new episodes, or C, because of protest of the episode about the proper way to gut a deer. And there's your quiz, ladies and gentlemen, right there. See, you can learn educational things here on Phil's Notebook. But then again, I could be wrong. They call me Phil.